It better be good, Simmons.
I'm sorry, sir, but it's an emergency. Can we meet?
Good God, man, it's 9 o'clock on Sunday morning. I'm about to go and play golf.
The money has to be moved to another account. One of us will have to go to Switzerland. Securimet's insurers are being more persistent than we anticipated.
I have told you not to mention that on an open line.
Can we meet, sir?
All right, all right. You better meet me at the club.
Mrs. Shipley?
Yes?
Hello, my name is Henry Crabbe. I'd like to talk to you about your husband.
Are you a policeman?
Yes. Thank you.
Somebody wants to make a film about Ken. Oh, I've heard it all now.
Well, it's true, actually.
Well, you can believe it if you want to. Me, I've been married to the man for 15 years. I've heard more fairy tales than you can imagine.
Can I have some up, Mum?
Yes, sir.
When did you last see him?
6 months ago. I had to tell him to go. It was getting too much. I was worried for the kids. Look, you can tell Barry Simmons to stop sending people round here. I haven't the foggiest where Ken is.
I'm nothing to do with Barry Simmons.
You're not from Beddingley, Nick?
No, no. I'm actually trying to help Ken.
Rosie, hurry up.
Ken's got this thing about Simmons, hasn't he?
That's one way of putting it, I suppose. Look, Ken and Barry Simmons were best mates. They were at school together. They joined the police together. It's funny. Ken was the bright one. He was the one destined for great things. Look at them now.
Yes, it can be very hard to take. I mean, it must have been hard for Ken.
Yeah. Particularly when Barry was moved to Beddingley. I mean, there they were working in the same nick. Barry could have made it easier for Ken, but he didn't. He was a bastard. Ken became obsessed with him. Barry Simmons had ruined his life, his career, even his marriage. It's unbelievable the mess people make of things, isn't it?
If I find him, is there anything you'd like me to say to him?
No.
You said you wanted to help my dad.
What?
You said you wanted to help my dad.
If I can, yes.
And you're not from Beddingley, Nick?
No.
All right, I'll tell you where he is. I've been there a couple of times, but it's difficult. Mum would kill me if she knew. We're not supposed to see him.
I understand.
Tell him from me it'll be all right. Mum will let him back, but he's got to stop this Barry Simmons stuff and he's got to knock the booze on the head. Tell him I'll help. I've looked up a phone number he can ring.
I'll tell him. I promise.
Simmons.
I'm sorry, sir, but it's an emergency. One of us will have to go to Switzerland. Security
insurers
are being more persistent than we anticipated.
This tape of Fisher and Simmons. There's a TV in the background. You can hear the music on the programme. It's an Australian soap opera.
So what?
This soap only goes out on weekdays. Fisher and Simmons are talking on a Sunday morning.
Oh, man, it's 9 o'clock on Sunday morning. I'm about to go and play golf.
The money has to be...
So, maybe it's a video. How did you find me, Crabbe?
Rose told me.
Where's Romney?
I don't know.
I'm second thoughts about Romney. Media types. What do I know about life? Oh, maybe I'll take it in the newspaper. One of the tabloids, why not?
I want to listen to the other tapes, Shipley.
Or maybe I'll write a book. Tell my own story. My own words.
Did you hear what I said?
Listen to what you want.
Now I understand.
Oh, yeah. You're a weird one, you are, Crabbe.
I shall want to take a couple of these tapes with me. One of them could be quite useful. It'll help me get you out of trouble.
Get me out of trouble? Simmons is the one who's in trouble.
Rosie asked me to give you a message. She says she thinks she might be able to square it with Jane for you to go back home. There are various conditions. Giving up drink, for example.
I'll go home when I'm ready. On my own terms. And I sorted that bastard Simmons and his rotten team. And I will sort him, Crabbe. Because I'm right. And sooner or later, the truth will come out and everybody will see I'm right.
I'm afraid it doesn't work like that, Ken. The truth will not out. Justice will not be done. And people will not see. Believe me. I know.
Yes, you're right. The background levels are all different. Whoever did this has snipped up half a dozen phone calls and then put the TV music on top. A plane flying over would have been better. That's the usual thing.
You see, when Shipley couldn't get anything incriminating on Simmons, he just had to fake it.
Oh, I'm devastated. I have a real feeling about the story, you know.
Try this one.
Oh, maybe it's all for the best. I mean, corrupt policemen, we've been there before, right? There are so many big issues out there now. The environment, Europe.
You may find this tape more interesting, Romney. It's got Fisher and Simmons discussing overtime.
Oh, overtime.
The police are undermanned, OK? To keep up with the workload, officers are doing thousands of hours of overtime and it's costing a fortune. Here, Simmons and Fisher are discussing how to cut it.
So?
So, how do they decide who gets the extra hours? Look, imagine, God forbid, Cambridge gets murdered. She'd end up all over the front page, right? Say you get murdered, it ends up underneath the gardening tips. Who gets the short straw in Fisher's cost-cutting scheme? Two murders, two investigations, and only enough overtime money for one of them. So who gets it? Publicity-wise, there's no contest. The front page murder gets it all. The other one gets put on the back burner. Now, some would call that responding to market conditions. I call it rough justice. Now, that's the story.
Yeah, I see your point, but, I mean, police overtime, it's a bit parochial, isn't it?
Yeah, this tape's fine. No one's tampered with this one.
Are you going to let me have the tape now, sir?
Not just now, Cambridge, no.